See, there are two basic principles on which that a transformer working depends. One is Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction. Another one is Lenz's law. Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction, it tells how much, what is the magnitude of EMF that is induced. Whereas Lenz's law will tell what is the polarity of EMF, because EMF has polarity, plus and minus, higher potential, lower potential. So Lenz's law will tell the polarity. So with these two laws, we will know what is the EMF and what is its polarity. Okay, so one by one we'll see. Okay, so we will take a simple example. So assume we have a coil. This is a coil, okay, and it's a rectangular coil. Just we represent it like that. It's a rectangular coil, okay, and these are the terminals, okay. So what do you find out here is that, so this is a coil, okay, this is a coil. So now assume that this coil is in the presence of a magnetic field. This coil is present, okay, in a magnetic field. So magnetic field in the sense, for example, see here. So if I put here North Pole, and if I put here South Pole, everyone know this thing that the flux lines travel like this from North to South Pole, from left side to right side, the flux lines will travel. Okay. For example, see something like that. The screen is visible to you now. So one pole is behind the screen, the other pole is, okay, on the screen. And in the sense, see, this is one direction. North Pole is left side. South Pole is right side. So you have two more directions. See, you have two more directions. So just assume yourself that these flux lines, the flux lines which I have drawn here, okay, these flux lines which are from left side to right side, just assume yourself that I am taking that this is a coil, okay, this is a coil, this is a coil, a conducting coil. So behind this coil there is one pole, and in front of that there is another pole. So is three-dimensional one, that we cannot imagine that, but we can only imagine, but we cannot put on the paper here, sir. But one thing I will tell, that we'll just give something, that some conventions, some symbols they have given, even in the textbooks, of several textbooks we'll find out that sometimes you'll find out the dot like this, okay, and sometimes you'll find out the cross like this. So cross and dot. So whenever you find out the dot, it means that the flux lines are coming towards you from the screen. Whereas this cross symbol, it tells the flux lines are going into the plane from you. So you are watching the screen here. So when you watch the screen here, assume that the flux lines are coming towards you from the screen, then that can be represented as dot. This is a dot. Whereas this cross symbol is there. So when you find out the cross symbol, it means the flux lines are going away from your eyes into the screen. So the flux lines are entering into the screen. So something like this. So either the lines are coming towards you, either the flux lines are coming towards you, or the flux lines are going away from you into the screen or into the plane. So I will say this thing, that dot represents coming coming out of the plane, whereas cross represents going into the plane. So this is the convention, because you see the left side picture, the arrows which I have shown, we can easily represent that. We can easily draw on the picture in a two dimension, that is from north side to south side, that flux lines are traveling like that. But you take the case, which case? That one pole is behind the screen, which you cannot see behind the screen. The another pole is in front of the screen. So the flux lines always travel through the plane. They travel through the plane. So when they are traveling through the plane, there are two possibilities. Either the flux lines are going into the plane, or they are coming out of the plane or out of the screen which you are seeing. So if it is coming out of the screen, you represented that as a dot. Otherwise, if it is coming or if it is going into the plane, you represented as cross. So now assume that I have a coil here. Now this coil is in the presence of a magnetic field. Now I will tell you where is the magnetic field here. So something like this. This is the magnetic field. I represent the magnetic field like this. This is the magnetic field. So what does this mean? Total thing I have done dots. So it means what? The flux lines are coming towards you from the plane. The flux lines are coming towards you from the screen or from the plane. So all the flux lines which I am drawing here, all the flux lines are having same direction. And what is that direction? The direction is that it is coming from the screen towards you. If it is cross, this is a cross symbol, it means the flux lines are going into the plane. Okay, so once we understand this one, a simple thing, okay, so we'll represent this as some this has some L. This length is L. This length is L. Okay. This length is L. Okay. So whereas this small distance, which is inside the coil, or you can say that onto the plane, I will say this thing. So I will take this as some x. X is the distance. See, x is which distance? The distance inside the coil. Whereas this height, what is this height? This height is same as L, because you see the geometry, simple geometry, you can understand. Okay. So this is L. So we can say this thing, that the coil is in the presence of a magnetic field, and the dots here I have shown, they represent the direction of magnetic flux lines. Now the magnetic flux lines are perpendicular to the plane of the coil. The plane of the coil, okay, I have drawn there, just a rectangular shape I have drawn, that's one. So this is the plane. This is the plane. Now, what about the flux lines? The flux lines are going into the plane, perpendicular to the plane. You see here, the flux lines are coming out of the plane perpendicularly. The flux lines are coming out of the plane. So dot means out of the plane. Cross means into the plane. That you remember. So I have drawn a coil which is on the screen and which is the plane there here. So whereas the flux lines which I have drawn here, they are coming out of the plane. So the flux lines and the plane of the coil, they are perpendicular. Okay. Assume that these flux lines have a flux density of B, where B is the flux density of the flux lines, or flux density of the magnetic field present here. Okay. That is B. Whereas L is one dimension, whereas x is another dimension. So we should not worry about the remaining flux lines which are outside the coil. We should worry only the flux lines which are inside the coil. Okay, so the dimensions of the flux lines which are inside the coil are L and X. L is one side, whereas X is another side. And the flux density of these flux lines is how much? B. Okay, once we know this, what is the flux? We know, everyone, that flux is the multiplication of flux density and area. Flux is the multiplication of flux density and area. So area is area of cross section, we can say like this. So that is equal B. What is the area here which is inside the coil? X is one side, L is another. So we can write L into X. So B L X. So area is L into X, whereas B is the flux density. So the flux is B into L into X. We got this expression. So once we got this expression, so assume that the flux density B is not a steady one, but it's a sinusoidally varying flux. It means, assume that it is Bm sin omega t. So it means the flux density or the magnetic field which is there here, that in which the coil is present, so in which the coil is present, so that that flux density is a sinusoidally varying flux density, that is Bm sin omega t. So then once you know what is B, then what is this equation? It becomes now phi is equal Bm, just substituting that, Lx sin omega t. Okay, so here I will represent Bm and Lx, Bm multiply Fx as phi m. So phi is equal phi m sin omega t. Yeah, what is phi m here from this equation? Phi m is Bm L X. So this is the equation you got. Okay, so here the flux density in which the coil is present is a sinusoidally varying one, and its expression is Bm sin omega t. Okay, once we got this, now what Faraday says is that EMF induced is the rate of change of flux linkages. So d psi by dt. So where psi is n into phi. Here in this particular problem, we are taking n as 1. You see here, only for simplification purpose, I have taken only 1. So it becomes now, d phi by dt. That is equal. Now what is phi? Phi m sin omega t. We got one expression here, phi m sin omega t. Then we substitute there. So if you substitute there, what you will get now? Differentiation of sine. Okay, it's a cos. So it becomes something like this. So omega phi m cos omega t. So this is EMF expression E. Okay, so we got EMF expression here. So how we got the EMF expression here? The simple thing, that we have taken a coil whose dimensions it is represented there. Okay, with those dimensions, it is present in the presence of a sinusoidally varying magnetic field whose flux density is Bm sin omega t. Then what is the flux you will get here from that physical dimensions? That it becomes phi m sine omega t. So when we do this entire simplification, we got this answer. So from this answer, what we can do is that, we got the EMF equation. So now I can write this EMF equation further. Okay, I can write this as further. So a simplification, it is nothing else there. Omega phi m, I can write this as sine omega t plus pi by 2. Yeah, cos omega t we can write as sin omega t plus pi by 2. So this is the expression for EMF. So from this expression, we can bring some conclusions. What are the conclusions? Now this is EMF expression. Okay, whereas this is flux expression. Now what is the difference you will find out between these two? What is the difference you will find out? One difference is that it is sin omega t here, whereas it is sin omega t plus pi by 2. So one difference is that the phase difference, between flux and EMF. The phase difference between phi and EMF is how much you got? You got 90 degrees. You see, just you see yourself, or pi by 2 radians is pi by 2. Okay, this is the phase difference between the flux and EMF. So this you find out. So as per Faraday's law, you find out what is the magnitude, that is what is the magnitude of EMF, that is omega phi m sine omega t plus pi by 2. Okay, now what about the polarity? We must understand the polarity also. Okay, so then Lenz's law states that, okay, so to bring this further, I would like to copy this picture here. Somewhere else I will copy and I will just explain. Okay, so what Lenz law says, I just now told you that Lenz law will tell you the polarity of the EMF. So what is the polarity of the EMF? So EMF is induced, where the EMF is induced here? EMF is induced, where it induced here? It induced between these two points. Which two points? These two points. This point A, point B. So across point A, point B, some EMF is induced. Now the question is that what is the polarity of this? So whether A is positive or B is positive, which is having higher potential. So definitely between A and B, one is positive, the other is negative. So which one is positive, which one is negative? So now this polarity will be decided by the Lenz law. So what Lenz law states is that, okay, so it says that Lenz law says that the response opposes the cause. So it means, what is the cause here? The magnetic field B, which is in this direction, that is, which is coming towards you. The magnetic field direction, what is the magnetic field direction? The magnetic field direction is that it is coming towards you. Okay, so it is coming towards you. So that is the magnetic field direction. So this magnetic field direction, okay, or this magnetic field, which is varying here, okay, which is varying and which is linking to your coil, that is the cause for this EMF. So now this EMF polarity is such a direction that it will oppose the cause. So it is oppose the cause in the sense what? It will oppose the magnetic field rising, or it will oppose the magnetic field linking. So then how I will explain is that, assume that I have a load here. Just let me take the load is a resistor, just for example. Okay, so it's a resistor. This is the load. Now I will connect the load to A and B here. Definitely this EMF I will connect here. Then if I connect the EMF here, what do you expect now? You will expect that the current flows in the, resistor. So if the current flows in the resistor, then that current which is flowing in the resistor, now some current is flowing. Now I'm not drawing the direction of the current here. I will tell you what is the direction. So I current flows. So assume that this is the resistor R. So when I close this path through a load and assume the load here is the resistor, then some current I flows through the resistor. Now this current which is flowing in the resistor, so it's a closed path through the coil. Now see here, it's a closed path through the coil. This is the closed path. This is the closed path. So through the resistor, then through the coil, it makes a closed path. Either this direction or in the opposite direction. Any one direction, it makes the closed path. It depends upon the polarity at A and B. It depends upon the polarity at A and B. Okay. So now we will take two cases. What are the two cases? First case I will take, A is positive. Okay. Yeah, I will take A is positive. A is positive, B is negative. We'll take this case. If I take this case, okay. So what is the direction of the current? Definitely the direction of the current will be like this. So the direction of current will flow like this. Then through the resistor it flows. Then after that it goes like this. Then after that it goes like this. It goes like this. And it makes the closed path like this. Okay. With this, it makes a closed path. Now we will see whether this polarity correct or not. How do we see whether this polarity correct or not? Is that, so we will take the help of another rule. What is that rule? Is that it's a thumb rule. It's a thumb rule. So thumb rule says that when some current is flowing into the conductor, the direction of the, okay. So then, just I will show you here. So we'll take the help of this one. Now you see here, let me bring this side. Okay. So see, first assumption is that A is positive, B is negative. This is the assumption I have taken. So if I take this assumption, then this is the direction of the current which I have shown in the picture. So if this is the direction of the current, then what is the direction of the flux? You see, I'm using this, the picture which I have shown here now, this picture. So with this picture, we can know what is the direction of the flux. What is the direction of the flux? If you know the direction of the current. So what is the direction of the current here? The direction of the current is this one. Okay, here in this direction. So coming to this case, which side? This side will come. In this side, the direction of the current I have drawn downwards because I have taken this as plus and this as minus. So if I take this as downwards, then what is the direction of the flux? Is it only two? See, let me tell you, only two directions of the flux is there. Either it is a dot or it is a cross. Two options are there, either dot or cross. Okay. So if it is a dot, then it is same direction as the original magnetic field, actual magnetic field. If it is cross, it is opposite to the actual magnetic field. Now, what the Lenz law states? The Lenz law states that it opposes the cause. So if it opposes the cause, it means that the actual magnetic field in which the coil present, it is dot. Whereas the magnetic field which will be produced because of this load current definitely should be a cross. Okay. If it is not cross, then our polarity is wrong. Now we'll check whether it is cross or dot. So how do we know is that the direction of the flux in this side, let me take this as which side I will take. This side I will take it as K side, whereas this side I will take it as L side. So K side, the direction of the current you got as downwards. So if you get the direction of the current downwards, you imagine yourself, what is the direction of the flux? What is the direction of the flux inside the coil? We want to know what is inside the coil. Whether the inside the coil is a dot or cross, use this picture. Using this picture, only thing is that whether the fingers, see, thumb you align along the direction downwards. This is the downward direction. So you align the thumb here. You align the thumb along the direction of the current here. So direction of the current is downwards here. So you align along with that. Then how your fingers are coming in the coil. If you just put yourself, then you will understand that. You will clearly understand this thing that. Okay. So you will get here dots. You will get dots. It means the fingers are pointing towards you. That is pointing are coming from the plane towards you. So you will get that this is a dot, this is a dot. So everywhere you get the dots. So if you get everywhere it is dot, then it is wrong. It is wrong. So it is not the polarity. The polarity which we have taken here, A is plus, B is minus, is not correct. Why it is not correct? Because if you take A is plus, B is minus, the direction of the current is like this. So if the direction of the current is like this, then the direction of the current on K side or on K side of that, you see here, it is downward. So you apply this right hand thumb rule. You apply this right hand thumb rule. Okay, here on the K side, that is align your thumb in the direction of the current, which is downwards here. Then you will find out that what you will find out is that inside the coil, the fingers are coming outside or towards you. It means it's a dot. It's a dot. So the answer is wrong. Then what is the actual polarity? Then what is the correct polarity? Definitely the correct polarity will be this is plus, sorry, this is minus and this is plus. Okay, so now you see if this is minus and this if this is plus, okay, if this is minus and if this is plus, then what is the polarity direction? The direction will be something different like this. Yes, so opposite direction. So like this. Now the green color one which I have drawn, now it is the correct polarity, the green color. Now you check yourself, when I draw this one, then once again you align with the thumb, then you will understand yourself is that this time the flux lines are crosses. So here inside that you will get crosses. So the actual magnetic field is dot, whereas the magnetic field which is created by the EMF induced is cross. So both are opposite. So this says, this is what Lenz's law states. So this is correct. So from this, B is positive. So B polarity is positive. The correct polarity is B is positive, whereas A is negative. This is the correct polarity. So B is positive, A is negative. Okay. So So this is how you get now. Okay. Okay, so now you see here. So with this the polarity you can easily find out now. Okay, so that's what says that Faraday's law states the magnitude how much you got, whereas the Lenz law states the polarity. So what the polarity this Lenz law states is that the polarity is that polarity is the correct polarity which produces a current in the coil, so that the current in the coil, okay, will produce another magnetic field, and that magnetic field is opposite to the actual magnetic field, that is B. So here you have two magnetic fields. One is the magnetic field which I have drawn here, dots, whereas the second one is the green color dots, green color crosses here, which is this magnetic field is because of the current in the load, and both the magnetic field should be opposite in direction. So if you want to get that opposite direction, then you will understand which polarity, which point A or B, which is positive, which is negative.